Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello and hi. Hello and hi everyone. Okay, we are from group 5. In this opportunity, we will present about testing the similarity of two proportions and testing the similarity of two variances. The member of group 5 is Khairul Mubin Fatiyadi, it's me. The number student is 410-1419-052. And then Ms. Bahul Bahri, 410-1410-55. For the testing, the similarity of the proportions will be explained by Bahri, and testing the similarity of two variances will be explained by me, Khairul Mubin Fatiyadi. Okay, let's start.
Okay, I will explain about the testing the similarity of two proportions. Suppose we have two binomial populations in which the proportions are obtained if an A is P hat 1 and P hat 2 independently of each population drawn a random sample of size N1 and N2. The proportion for that event not in the symbol is X1 over N1 and X2 over N2. Two-tail test. For hypothesis testing, the null hypothesis is P hat 1 equal to P hat 2 and the alternative hypothesis equal to P hat 1 is not equal to P hat 2. And the second, determine the level of significant alpha. And the third step, testing criteria, accept the null hypothesis if minus gets a half of 1 minus alpha equal less than that less than z a half of 1 minus alpha. Otherwise, reject the null hypothesis. With z of a half of 1 minus alpha is obtained from the standard normal distribution list with probability a half of 1 minus alpha. The first step is statistical calculation based on research data or sample that using the normal distribution approach. Z equal to P hat 1 minus P hat 2 over the square root of PQ times 1 over N1 plus 1 over N2 is equal to Z equal to X1 over N1 minus X2 over N2 over the square root of PQ times 1 over N1 plus 1 over N2 with P is equal to X1 plus X2 over N1 plus N2 and Q is equal to 1 minus P. And the last step is take conclusion based on result 3 and 4. For the second is right-tail test. The hypothesis testing is the null hypothesis equal to P hat 1 equal to P hat 2 and the alternative hypothesis is P hat 1 greater than P hat 2. And the second step, determine the level of significant alpha. And the third step, in the third step, testing criteria, reject the null hypothesis if that is greater than or equal that a half minus alpha and accept the null hypothesis if that less than that a half minus alpha. That a half minus alpha is obtained from the standard normal distribution list with probability zero the half minus alpha. Then based on research data or sample, second using the normal distribution approach. That equal to P hat 1 minus P hat 2 over the square root of PQ times 1 over N1 plus 1 over N2. That implies that equal to X1 over n1 minus x2 over n2 over the square root of pq times 1 over n1 plus 1 over n2 with p as x1 plus x2 over n1 plus n2 and q is equal to 1 minus p. And the last is take conclusion based on result 3 and 4. For the example, in Tembalang sub-district, out of 2050 elementary school students, 150 students like math. In Numpati sub-district, out of 300 elementary school students, 162 students like math. With level of significant alpha is equal to 5%, test for significant difference in preference mathematics in first sub-district. The solution for this example is we have x1 is equal 150. x2 we have 162. The n1 is equal to 250, and n2 is equal to 300. So write the procedure. Besides the hypothesis testing, the null hypothesis is p-1 is equal p-2, and the alternative hypothesis is p-1 is not equal to p-2. In the second level of significance, we know that alpha is equal to 5% or 0.05. And the third testing criteria using two-tail testing. Except the null hypothesis is minus that a half of 1 minus alpha less than z a half 1 minus alpha equal to minus z a half 1 minus 0.05 less than z a half 1 minus 0.05. That equal that minus z 0.475 less than z 0.475. The value of z 0.475 is equal 1.996. So we get minus 1.96 less than 1.96. In the fourth step, compute the sample statistic. P is equal to x1 plus x2 over n1 plus n2 is equal 150 and 162. 150 plus 162 over 250 and 300 is equal to 0.5673. And then we get Q is equal to 1 minus P equal to 1 minus 0.5673 equal to 0.4327. And then we substitute to the set. It's equal to x1 over n1 minus x2 over n2 over the square root of pq times 1 over n1 plus 1 over n2 equal to 150 over 250 minus 162 over 300 over the square root of 0.4 5.673 × 0.4327 × 1/260 + 1/300. That we get that is equal to 1.43. The conclusion of the
Excuse me, Bahri. Okay, I will continue. So the conclusion is since -1.96 less than z, that is z is 1.43 and less than 1.96, then we accept H null, null hypothesis. Thus, P1 hat is equal to P2 hat. It means that there is no significant difference in reference mathematics in Tembalang and Gunung Pati district. Okay, any question for testing of similarity of two proportion? Any question? If there is no question, I'll continue it. Okay, continue.
Not yet, Mufin. You can continue your presentation.
Thank you. The second is testing the similarity of two variances. Testing the similarity of two variances when estimating the difference of means in the last week and testing the similarity of or difference of two means, it is emphasis the assumption that the two populations have the same variance in order to estimate and test them. So in the previous topic, talk about difference of means and similarity of means, but the variance is usually same. But in this topic, the variance is possible to differ. In the case of variance, only the approximation method that has been used so far. Therefore, it is necessary to test the similarity of two or more variance. That's right, because we have to test the similarity of two proportion, two variance. I mean, population with the same variance are called populations with homogeneous variances. If the population has different variance, it's called a population of heterogeneous variances. Okay. There are three tests in the testing of the similarity of two variances. Similar to before, the similarity of two proportion, the variances, there are three. Two-tailed test, right-tailed test, and left-tailed test. For two-tailed test, first step is hypothesis testing. We state the hypothesis. Null hypothesis is the variances is equal to variances, null variances, and alternate hypothesis is equal, is not equal. Then the second step is determine the level of significance. alpha. The third is testing the criteria, except it's null or null hypothesis if f 1 minus a half of alpha dfn comma dfd less than f a half of alpha dfn comma dfd. Otherwise, reject it's null. We have the new variable, new something new, that is f, because if in the test of similarity to variances, we use f distribution, so we use f with f beta dfn dfd obtained from f distribution list with probability beta. F the f distribution list, you can see that in the appendix 2 table 8, the degree of freedom numerator n1 minus 1 dfn is degree of freedom numerator, and degree of freedom denominator dfd, that is n2 minus 1. And the fourth step is statistical calculation based on research data samples taken where sample of the first population has size n1 and variances as 1 square, as well as sample of the second population has size n2 and variances as 2 square. The formula is f is equal to S1 square per S2 square. The last step is take conclusion based on results 3 and 4. The second test is Rankine test. The first step is similar, hypothesis testing, but for the population of variance is greater than. And then determine the level of significance alpha, and then testing criteria. Reject null hypothesis or H null if F greater than or equal to F alpha DFN DFD. Otherwise, accept H null, or we can say fail to reject H null with F beta DFN DFD. DFN is freedom degree of freedom numerator, and DFD is degree of freedom denominator. Okay, the fourth step is also similar, statistical calculation based on research data samples take where sample of the first population has size n1 and variance as 1 square, as well as sample of the second population has size n2 and variances as 2 square. The formula is also same, f is equal to s12 and s2 square. And the last step is take conclusion based on result 3 and 4. The step 3 and step 4. Also, for left-tile tests, first is we state the hypothesis, but the difference is at this, at alternate hypothesis. Alternative hypothesis is variance population is less than with the null variance population. And the second is determine the level of significance alpha. Answer is testing criteria. Reject at null if f less than f1 minus alpha dfn dfd. Otherwise, accept at null with f beta dfn dfd obtained from the f distribution list with probability beta, degree of freedom numerator. This is degree of freedom numerator and degree of freedom denominator. And the fourth is autosimilar statistical calculation based on research data samples taken where sample of first population has size N1 and variances S1 square, as well as sample of the second population has size N2 and variances S2 square. The formula is also same. F is equal to S1 square per S2 square. Fifth, take conclusion based on result 3 and 4. Okay. For example, it is known that the data of the income of the people in city A and city B. Then some samples are taken from two cities, city A and city B. Because there are differences in urban environment, it causes the difference in income. We want to test this claim using a 5% level of significance. The following data are obtained. G1 in million rupiah, 1.7, 5.1, 1.4, 0.7, 2.5, 4.0, 3.8, 2.0, 3.1, 5.0, 1.5. At the city B, million in the million rupiah, 1.6 million rupiah, 2.1, 3.1, 1.4, 2.2, 2.1, 2.6, 3.2, 3.4. Okay, let's see the solution. Solution given, alpha is 5% or is equal to 0.05. Population 1, we have 1 point and so on, 1 thing. And population 2, 1.6, 2.1, and so on. Then we have n, and 1 is 11. I'm sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. S1 squared. We should find the variance of population 1 first, and we get 2.266. And for the population variance 1 is this is as the variable. And for population 2, there are 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. And we get, after calculation, we get the variance of population 2 is 0.504. And then state the null and alternate hypothesis. And we use the two-tail test. In this, testing criteria, F1 minus the half of alpha, DFN, DFD, less than F, less than F, half alpha, DFN, DFD. And then we input the alpha, the given alpha is 0.05, and DFN, we know that DFN is N1 minus 1. So N1 is 11 minus 1, then we get 10. DFD, we know that N2 is 9, and then 9 minus 1 is 8. And we have 4.3 less than F less than 5.81. We get the interval by using table 8 appendix 2. And then next steps is statistical calculation based on research data sample. We know that the formula is F is equal to S1 square per S2 square. And we input S1. This is S1, and S2, this is S2, and we get F is approached to 4.496. The conclusion, since 4.30 less than F, that is 4.496 less than 5.81, then null hypothesis is accepted, or we can say as failed to reject. Thus, the French population 1 is equal to French population 2. It means both of the French of population is same, or both population is homogeneous. Any question? That's all our presentation.
I'm sorry, Mubin.
Yes. Okay, what's wrong?
Hello.
Yeah.
I want to ask, what's the advantage for us of testing two variants and testing two proportions? What's the advantage?
Oh, advantage. Okay, let's see the first again. Slide. Okay. This is for the testing the similarity of two variants first. Okay. The variants. Sometimes when we estimate the difference of means, the similarity of means, we assumption of the two population have the same variance. So in the case of variances, only the approximation, only approach, not. Sometimes it's not equal, sometimes it's not same. For the population with have same variance, we can call them as homogeneous variances. But if the population has different variances, it's called a population with heterogeneous variances. So we can know which this population has homogeneous variances or heterogeneous variances. If the homogeneous variances, so we can estimate the difference of means and the similarity of means without find the similarity of two variances. But if the variances is different, so we can find them. That's all what I get from my understanding, or maybe Bari want to additional opinion for Frida question. Excuse me, Bari, are you in here?
Interruption.
Yes.
Mr. Qaidul Mubin.
Yes.
Your slide, the last slide or slide before last? The last slide.
Before the last, because the last slide there is the exercise.
Yes.
After example, there is last exercise.
Slide, yes. Last slide. Epcon. Yes, Epcon itu. There are, you write Epcon, Epapil, yes. They like this. How to write it's upside down, terbalik ya. Yeah.
Oh,
jadi, it's upside down, terbalik. You write Epapil less than Epcon and less than Epapil. Seharusnya menulisnya tuh Epcon more than 4.30 and less than 5.81. Esther. Jadi itu dibalik, Mas.
Oh iya.
Yeah. Ya. Jadi menulisnya if you write seperti ini, itu terbalik kan, mau membuktikan yang paling atas itu.
Yeah. Ya,
jadi tapi kan kita punya data yang F gone more than 4.30, etc. Itu yang tulis pertama itu yang angka itu terus ke atas. Ya. Jadi kan mau membuktikan yang paling atas itu loh, ya. Itu menulisnya. Kan kalau menulisnya seperti ini kan seakan-akan sudah loh. Kok tiba-tiba F tabel lebih kecil, F hitung lebih kecil itu. Jadi balik aja itu ya.
Iya.
Nah, jadi itu data dengan kamu terus baru menunjukkan bahwa F count, F hitung itu berada di antara F tabel. Itu ya, paham ya?
Iya, paham, Pak. Terima kasih atas koreksinya, Pak. Atau Bapak ada tambahan buat pertanyaannya Firda? Apa manfaat?
Enough. Apa itu? You continue present about testing hypothesis the similarity of two variant. And yes, please continue present testing hypothesis about similarity of two variant.
Okay, thank you, sir. Okay. The next is exercise. This is the problem. From the two student population, the students' achievement was measured. From the first population, 10 students were measured in fact as 1 squared is equal to 224.7. From the second population, it was measured 13 students. It turned out that S2 squared is equal to 37.2. With alpha is equal to 10%, that's whether the two populations are homogeneous. Okay.
Ya, sekarang untuk semua yang apa itu peserta selain presenter, silahkan berebut menjawab ini. Menjawabnya tuh boleh pakai apa itu boleh di WA-kan, jadi ditulis di kertas, di foto, terus di WA-kan, di-upload di WA grup. Nanti presenter, siapa yang duluan mengupload di situ, presenter menilai membahasnya. Kalau memang sudah sesuai dengan, benar ya, sudah benar sesuai dengan kunci-kunci jawaban dari presenter, maka mendapatkan nih, skor, ya, mendapatkan skor. Siapa? Silakan. Selain kelompok presenter ya. Silakan. Cepet-cepetan ya. Cepat-cepatan. Paling cepat menulis di kertas terus diupload di WA. Ya, siapa yang mengupload pertama itu dibahas oleh presenter. Sudah benar atau belum? Kalau belum benar ya dipersilakan lain yang lainnya. Kalau sudah benar ya bilang aja bahwa itu is right, benar sehingga saya catat mendapatkan nilai atau skor. Silakan.
I'll give you time, how many minutes would you need? 5 minutes or 10 minutes?
10 minutes.
Okay. The time is set 10:45. So I'll wait you until 10:55. Okay.
Interruption. If no one has solved this problem, please the presenter to explain the solution of the problem.
Okay, so I'll present again.
Slowly to explain the solution.
Okay, I'll try.
Ya, pelan-pelan saja supaya yang lainnya tuh mengerti, memahami ya. Penjelasannya pelan-pelan saja.
Ya, ya. Plus, first we analyze the problem. We have 10 students as N1 10, and S1 squared is 24.7, and from the second population, it was measured 13 students. So we have N2 is equal to 13, and S2 squared is equal to 37.2. We have S2 squared is equal to 37.2. So we have the given data. Okay, that's the first step. And the second step, state the null and alternate hypothesis. Its null is Francis 1 is equal to Francis 2, H1, alternate hypothesis is Francis population 1 is not equal to Francis population 2. And then the level of significant alpha is equal to 10%. We have alpha is equal to 10%. Okay, until now, is there a question? Okay, no question. Okay, for testing criteria, we have the formula for testing criteria, F1 minus a half of alpha, dfn, dfd, less than F the con F less than F 1 over a half of alpha DFN DFD. We input the given data. We have F for 1 minus a half of 0.1 and DFN is 10, DFD is 12. Oh, I forget. Okay, I forget to how to. We have this. Oh, how to say? This value from the appendix data. From the appendix to table 8. Okay, I'll solve you appendix to table 8. Here it is. This is the appendix to tables for statistical table and for F distribution at table 8. Where is table 8? Yeah. Okay. This is, we have F a half of 0.1, so that is 0.05. It's as the right tail area, and DFN for degree of freedom numerator, this row, and DFD for this column. Okay, we have DFN is 10, so we find DFN is 10 and DFD is 12. This is the table. DFN is 10. Okay, not yet. DFN is 10 and DFD is 12. Okay, mana. And then this one is 10 and 12. DF 10 and DFD is 12, right tail area 0.05, yeah. Oh, there is no data. I think Oh, I'm sorry. This is not complete for table. Okay. Or you can find them at the internet. So,
excuse me, Mubin. I want to ask something.
Yeah.
In the previous slide, you say that the Fn is n1 minus 1.
Yeah.
But here, you write that the Fn.
Okay.
Why not 9?
Okay, my bad. Oh, yeah. You're right. Oh, my bad. It showed 9, yeah. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Why you write 10 here?
Okay. That's my fault. My bad. This is should be 9 and this should be 12. Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. My fault. Hey, you're right. Thank you.
You are welcome.
Okay, let's see. 9 and 12. Where it is and brother, here it is. 9 and 12. And for the a half of alpha is 0.05. That's right. Okay. And this is for DFN 9, D12. And we have 0.050. And we get 2.80. So we have 2.8. I'm sorry. Oh, I'm sorry. So actually I have calculated it previously and write down again, and I did a mistake in my previous calculation. This is 9. I'm sorry. This is 9, so we get 2.8. similar way to find this, and then after testing the criteria, we calculate statistical calculation based on research data. We have S1 square is 24.7 and per 37.2, and we get F is approach 0.664. And the conclusion, since 0.3257 less than F, that is F, the com F is 0.664 and less than 2.8, then null hypothesis is accepted, or you can say fail to reject. Thus, the population one is equal to Francis population one is equal to Francis population two. It means both of them is homogeneous. Both of the Francis population is same, or both population is homogeneous. Okay, that's all my presentation. That's all my. And thank you for the correction. Any question? I will share you the appendix table in the group. Or you want to my explanation in Bahasa? No? Okay.
For all lectures participants.
Yes.
Sorry, Mupin.
Where is the difficulty in solving question number one? Where is the difficulty in solving question number about a table? You can you can read the table. All my student, you can read table. Dapatkah membaca table-nya? Apa ada kesulitan untuk membaca table-nya? Kok tadi nobody tidak ada seorang pun yang maksudnya bisa menjawab soal nomor satu?
Iya Pak, masih belum paham untuk baca tabelnya.
Tabelnya sekarang sudah paham atau ada yang masih belum paham? Kalau misalnya belum paham, please presenter display the tabel, ya. And apakah semua sudah punya tabel? Jangan-jangan tidak ada tabel di hadapan kalian. Ada enggak? Siapa yang belum punya? Kalau enggak punya, please presenter display the table and you screenshot ya, yeah, di foto.
Okay, sir. And I have upload the appendix to statistical table on our group, inference scale statistical group. You can see.
Yes, thank you. Yes, yes. Please upload in GWE.
Okay. Okay, I will explain you again. You need it. This is critical value for F distribution. Okay. For this time, I will explain you in Bahasa. Okay. Okay ya. Punya alpha. Nah, alpha nah, tadi itu tuh di sini sebagai rectal area. Nah, kemudian kita pokoknya di tabel ini yang diperlukan itu ada tiga. Degrees of freedom numerator, DFN, nyari DFN. Nah, DFN itu apa? N1 dikurangi 1. Nah, kemudian kita juga butuh degrees of freedom numerator, DFD. DFD itu apa? N2 dikurangi 1. Kemudian, right cell area, itu dari alpha, datanya itu. Nah, itu. Misalnya tadi ada yang 1 minus setengah alfa, ada juga yang setengah alfa, ada juga yang alfa. Nah, itu soalnya ini. Nah, setelah kita dapat, soalnya ya, kita punya di FN itu 6. Ya, datanya ada 7, populasi 1 ya. Kemudian di FN-nya itu 6. Kemudian, populasi kedua, misalnya ada 4. Nah, 4. Ada 4 data, kemudian di FD-nya itu 3 berarti. Tadi 6 sama 3. Misalnya ya alpha. Alpha kita punya berapa ya? 10%. Nah, 10% setengah alpha misalnya. Setengah alpha berarti kan 5%. 5% itu 0,05. Nah, ini 6, 3, 0,5. Tarik, ceret. Pertemuannya, nah ada di sini, nah berarti 8,94 begitu kawan-kawan.
Continue problem 2 ya, masalah yang kedua. Tapi nganu ya, waktunya habis ternyata ya, sudah waktunya selesai ya. sudah anu apa mix homework ya. Make homework ya sebagai tas tugas ya. Ada berapa? How many your problem? Ada berapa kayaknya soalmu?
There is three exercise. There is three problems.
With testing hypothesis and the similarity of variant, and from testing hypothesis the similarity of two proportion, how many?
Oh, I mean there is one for two proportion, three similarity of two proportion, and total? There are two for the variances, similarity of variance.
Total problem, five or six?
The total problem, there are three.
Oh, three. Problem ban sudah tadi sudah anu ya diselesaikan di sini. Please apa diminta untuk menyelesaikan sebagai tugas rumah, terus harus dikumpulkan tanggal berapa ke press center gitu ya?
Iya kak.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Ya, dan itu ya bisa kalian bisa press center bisa menutup ini diskusi dan apa namanya di langsung berdoa penutupan ya.
Okay. Ya. Yeah. Thank you for your participant. That's all our presentation from group 5. We hope you get our point and you can understand about the testing of similarity of two proportion and two variances. And let's close our meeting with prayer. Together, praying begin. Enough. Thank you. The last say. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Yes. Please give applause for presenter. Give applause for presenter. Yeah. Give applause for presenter. To a presenter and my all student and see you next week. Yes, see you next week. Thank you.
See you. Yes. See you, sir.
See you, sir.
See you, sir. Thank you.